If you're already a subscriber, I sure do appreciate it. If not, consider doing so. And don't forget to give this video a thumbs up.
Hey everybody, it's John, and I gotta tell you, it's getting hot here in the Upper East Side of Texas, especially in this side of the shop over through here, and it is time to move on to the next chapter. We just finished up the little Stewart 10V engine, or at least the building of it, and as I said in the last video, I'm going to have to tear it down now, build the gaskets for it, polish all the mating surfaces, polish up all the cast iron on it, go ahead and paint it up, make it look real pretty. And that's going to take a while, and I'm going to do that at my own pace. Probably will not be doing a lot of videos step by step. Probably what I will do, though, is bring in maybe some up-to-date videos, maybe once every 5 or 6 weeks, and just show you what I have done. So what am I going to do next? I've had several people ask me that. Well, what I'm going to do next, I've got it right behind me here. Let me show you what it is. This is a little gasoline engine that I built about 15 years or so ago, and it was from plans out of Model Tech magazine, which is no longer in print. But this is an Upshur engine, and it is a throttle governing engine. It is not a hit and miss engine, but it is a throttling governor engine, which means that the speed is controlled by the carburetor jet up through here. Now, there's going to be a twofold video series. I'm going to be building a carburetor. This carburetor here is not working like I would hope it would be working. So I'm going to rebuild it. I'm going to need to do some work around the base and everything on it. And I'm toying with the idea of perhaps building another one of these engines right here. They're very, very easy to build. If you're looking to build an internal combustion engine, you could do a whole lot worse than building this engine right here. There are several engines out there that you can do this from Home Shop Machinist. Now, these plans are copyrighted. I'll just tell you right up front, I will not be publishing the plans. The gentleman, Harold Upshur, died several years ago, but his family still sells these plans. I think his daughter still sells these plans. If they are still available, I will put them in the link to this video. You can get a whole set of plans. It's about 5 or 6 engines in there. I've built 2 of the engines, and there's 2 more that I want to build, and I think thinking about the possibility of doing that. But in the interim, what I'm going to be doing is rebuilding the carburetor. Now, here's why the carburetor needs to be rebuilt. The carburetor on this engine is a very, very simple mixer. It's really not a carburetor at all. It really is the air's coming in, and there's a jet that meters the fuel as it goes in. Very, very simple. When I built that carburetor, when I was doing this about 15 years ago, I did not do the job that I needed to do on that carburetor, and it does not run as well as I would like it to run. So as you can see, it's kind of choppy a little bit. It's very tricky to adjust. So we're going to start the series of building the carburetor for the little Upshur engine next, or the mixer for that. Then we're going to move on to some next projects. Guys, if you're not already a subscriber, I hope you consider doing so. If you are, I really appreciate you doing so. Share the videos, do a thumbs up, comment, put all your comments down below. Tell me some experiences that you've had building carburetors. Tell me the experiences that you've had building mixers. If anyone out there has built one of these engines before, put that in a comment below and perhaps send along a video, and then I will link back to that. So until we start that carburetor on the next video series from the Upper East Side of Texas, this is John. We'll see you on the next video.